every day we're taking it, and it's normally there's a lot of people on board. It's not empty.
But a tightened budget means tightened programs and possibly eliminating DC's circulator buses.
It's definitely a tight budget season, and I think cuts definitely had to be made somewhere.
And that is raising concerns for those who depend on it.
What about the routes that are unique to Circulator? There's a lot of questions about the timing, what's going to happen to the routes, if there's some routes that WMATA will offer that will be comparable.
Benjamin Lin, spokesman for ATU Local 689, says while he isn't sure WMATA can make up for Circulator routes that would be cut, he does say a single mass transportation system throughout the region is a good thing.
The union has a long time been a proponent of having a single mass transit system unified throughout the region, and the proposal to kind of fold Circulator into WMATA is a step in the right direction, as long as it does right by the workers and the riders.
This doesn't mean there won't be buses available. DDOT and WMATA are discussing the future of the DC Circulator. Even so, some Circulator routes will likely be eliminated, like the National Mall route.
Renald Bordog, who is visiting DC, says taking away the unique Circulator bus routes would affect tourists like himself.
It's very nice to use it because normally it's a long walk to go from one end to the other end, so we take the Circulator to go wherever we want.
Lynn still feels strongly about having a single coordinated transit system.
We're going to need to get to the point where we need to start re-emphasizing on public transit.
And Bordog says taking away the buses takes away a part of the experience.
No, it's important for the tourists.
For CNS TV, I'm Alana Mutnick.